What a night on Survivor. There was a tribal shake-up when contestants were asked to drop their buffs.
Yeah, and in the end, not even Nina could prevent her mother, the queen of Survivor, from going home.
Am I expecting it tonight? I wouldn't be surprised if I got a couple of votes my way. Let me look into her eyes.
No, don't look at me, look at him.
Sixth person voted out of blood versus water. Sandra.
I've played for 166 consecutive days. No one can take that away from me.
Sandra, the tribe has spoken.
I know. Play to win, guys, okay? And if it doesn't benefit you, don't go along with just any plan.
Tactical call, that one there. Yeah, Survivor royalty. Sandra joins us now from her home in North Carolina. Hello, Sandra.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for inviting me.
Of course. We have absolutely loved you on Survivor. It was great to have you on our one here now as well. Day 16 is a cursed day for you in the game of Survivor. Mm. Last night was that day. Were you worried deep down your time on Australian Survivor was up?
I was, but I wasn't worried until I got to Tribal Council and then listening to the answers, looking around, no one was looking at me in the eyes. And I was like, oh my God, today is day 16 all over again for me. They're after me. And I started pleading my case immediately when I felt it. And Jordy started interrupting me and saying, guys, stick to the plan. And I'm looking around like, who's he talking to? Who is these guys? Let's stick to the plan. And then I realized when I started talking to my daughter that, yes, it was me.
Oh, we're hoping that your Wi-Fi will survive this interview, Sandra. You are Survivor royalty. You've played the game 6 times now. You've been crowned sole Survivor twice. How does the Australian game compare to the game in the States?
It's so much harder. Like, Australian Survivors, 47 days, $500,000, 24 people. The weather is extreme. The challenges are horrible. They get harder and harder by the day, where in the U.S. it's just 39 days. It's $1 million. The challenges get easier the further we are in the game. And the weather is bearable because we're usually in Fiji or Samoa and Panama, like I did all those different islands. So all in all, like, Survivor Australia was by far the hardest Survivor that I had ever dealt with. But the personalities were gracious. Everyone was so wonderful to me. I didn't leave the game having any ill will towards anyone, which usually in the American version, there's one or two people that I have issues with. After the game is over, but I really left Australian Survivor okay. Like, I'm fine. I don't hold it against anyone. I knew my days in the game were numbered, being that I was, you know, coming into the game already a winner and an outsider. And I did the best I could.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, last night you were reunited with your daughter, Nina. Now, we were expecting this at some stage. I thought it was going to be a cliffhanger maybe a little bit later on. But what was it fun to play the game you know so well with Nina? And do you ultimately think that put maybe a bigger target on your back?
Well, I'm not going to say it put a bigger target on my back, but I was hoping no one would know that she was my daughter in the first place. I got the impression that we were going to go into the game separate, and unless we told people that we were related, no one would know. But then we show up in a helicopter, so that didn't help. But while we were in quarantine, when we were rewatching all the seasons just to familiarize ourselves with specific players that might be coming out there, I said, baby, if you don't have an idol and you can't save me, don't put your neck on the chopping block trying to save me if you can't, because you're only one person. One person can't play this game alone. There was still a lot of game left, you know, so many days still left. And I felt like I didn't want her to put someone else's name down and then have an issue with that person when Tribal Council was over and she had to come back to camp. So if there was nothing she could do, write my name down, I was going to be fine. I didn't want to take her down with me.
It's brutal, though, isn't it? I mean,
yeah,
your own
really
daughter
is.
Threw you out to save herself. Have you taken her out of the will, or that's all forgiven?
So I told her she had to move out, which she did about 2 weeks ago. But she was looking for an apartment anyways, because my husband was retired and we'd been gone for 8 years. And now I'm home. We're moving back in. So then her and her boyfriend moved out. It wasn't because of me, but no, Survivor is a hard game. And it's even harder when you're playing with a loved one, because usually when I play by myself, I don't care about the repercussions of my actions.
Yeah.
Playing with a loved one, everything has a repercussion. So I had to be careful to navigate and be careful that I didn't hurt her game because of my antics and the things that I do on Survivor.
Yeah, you play the game and you play it so well. Mel's name was thrown around camp, as was yours. But Shay ended up playing her immunity idol. Would you have done that? I mean, was that a bit of a rookie move?
No, Shay needed to play her idol because it kept coming up. And the minute someone plays their idol, it goes back into play. And maybe I have a shot at finding it next. So you want to flush out an idol in hopes that you go searching for it and find it. Mel's name was thrown out because she got injured 2 to 3 challenges before that. And her ankle was constantly wrapped. And she was always walking slow and walking with a limp. That's why when they said, you know, Mel's going home, it made sense. She was injured. So that's why I bought a hook, line, and sinker. But I had gone to do an interview in the water. They showed me in the water sitting on a rock. I did that interview right before tribal council. So once I finished, we went to tribal council, and then they told everyone, okay, we got a 5-minute lockdown. And that's when my daughter found out within those 5 minutes that they were coming after me. And there was nothing she could say to me. Because, you know, now we had to go to tribal council. The talking was over. So it was just, you know, bad timing. And but I'm good. I'm solid. I'm excited for tonight's episode. I'm excited for the entire season. It's going to be good. So I want everyone to still stay tuned in.
Well, you know, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. Nina seems hungrier than ever to win this game. Has she got what it takes to follow through?
She has what it takes. I am so proud of her. She's been watching Survivor. She was 5 since I was on. She's never missed a season. She went deep into the casting process for our Survivor, David versus Goliath. I thought she'd get picked to play. She didn't. She was heartbroken. So she was hungry for this opportunity. And that is the only reason I went to the Outback, because I knew, I was like, oh my God, I don't want to compete in Survivor over there. It's brutal.
And now your daughter is flying the flag. Australian Survivor Blood versus Water continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play on demand. Queen Sandra, we bow to you. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. Take care, guys.
Bye. Thank you. You've been great.